Heavy. Yep, indeed. Back to the Future, NECA figures here. We're talking 6.5 inches or 17 centimetres for each of these figures. We'll look at two of them together. One was a US Walmart exclusive, which made its way around the world in different forms. Walmart, Target? I think it was Walmart. The other one is, again, I picked this up, Dark Side Toys, because they ended up getting this one back into stock. So they basically, Walmart had a kind of short exclusive window, and then it got to basically go to fan channels, which I think is fabulous and is the way forward for Hasbro. None of your exclusives, and then they never go anywhere. Get them exclusive, but then 3 months later, get them to other stores so we can all get them. Anyway, we'll get a look at these two figures. They're pretty cool. There's a lot of features with them, so I'll run through all of them just shortly. But you got to take note of that packaging, first of all. It is pretty gorgeous, and all of them in the Back to the Future series look very, very good. Not quite sure why we've got this really big, ugly sticker on the box, because it would have been fine without it, because it was a really nice box as it was, but there you go. They've stuck this kind of sticker on there. Yuck. Anyway, nice shot from the movie. Drew Struzan there doing that just classic artwork, 1985. We get the side there, Ultimate Marty McFly, this one. And on the back of the box, you can see you get a couple of looks. You get Marty with guitar, you get Marty with video camera. Watch that video camera, little breakable bits on that one. And skateboard, and loads of other accessories. Got a couple of other ones, the Back to the Future 2, Marty McFly and Biff Tannen, etc. to review. UPC on the Ultimate Marty is there. And again, we'll put a link to Darkside below. And if they've sold out, eBay. So check that in the description. This one being the Walmart exclusive was slightly different, and it takes the comic that George in the movie had in his hand. Something's gone weird here. I don't quite know. I don't want to pick the sticker up, but something's been covered up. I don't know why. Maybe that's why they added the stickers or something. I don't know. Anyway, Shocking Science Fiction Stories is on the front, and we get this cool Pulp Fiction-esque comic from the days with a yellow vehicle, which again just happens to look like a Gullwing DeLorean. So just classy, classy stuff. On the side, Ultimate Marty McFly Tales from Space is what this is. And again, you get a couple of looks there. One with the hood up, one with the hood down, and you can take the hood off if you want. That is that UPC. Alrighty, so let's get a look at this Marty first of all. He comes with a bunch of different looks. Let me bring the camera in and we'll get some light on him so you can see. Facial sculpt straight off the bat. I quite like this face here, the shocked face. Look, it's not quite facial scan tech. It's not absolutely jumping out that it's Michael J. Fox, but it's doing a pretty good job, I have to say. And the likeness seems to be some form of applying that kind of facial scan-like kind of little almost kind of digits across the face. It doesn't look to be hand-painted, so there's something going on there. But it's nicely done. Doesn't look too bad. Doesn't look too shabby, especially if you're going to have the hood down. What's the point? So there you go. So again, you can swap this head off if you want. Just watch the head. Oh my god, this is going to take forever. Let me show you the other head here. You can see. So it's essentially the same. There's really not any difference, but with hair. So I'm not going to faffle around with this because there's too many looks to look through, but you can see pretty much, whoops, no mega difference in each one. Again, they're going for the same paint, same facial sculpt, so it's hair. Hair is the difference, and it's pretty good. They've done a fair job. We'll get a better look at the hair sculpt on the other Ultimate Marty McFly, but he's got that shocked face. That's pretty cool, actually. That's not too bad captured from Michael J. Fox at all. Some nice rosiness in the cheeks. So, you can, as I said, just have Marty with that head. You can have Marty here with just this look. Or, if you apply all the parts and pieces, you can begin to build up as much as you want of the Tales from Space comic alien or radiation suit. There we go. And then you can apply, it's a little bit weird and fiddly, you can have these parts here, for example, clip on, and you'll see a little lip there. It takes a little faffing around, but it kind of works out not too bad, and you get the gist. So you can kind of have this. It doesn't quite work, and it's a little weird, but with a lot of faffing, you can kind of, there you go, you can get the Marty Take me to your leader. I am your father. So it's a nice touch. You can just have the hood, they've included a huge lump of plastic basically just lying on the ground. As such, it doesn't really, it's just a piece you can have sitting there if you want. Or you can take all this off. You can have the hood half on at the back. You can just have it sitting half on. And this other part then goes on to the front to kind of clip underneath if you want to do that, as the helmet sits above. You'll know what I mean. Anyway, you get different options, more than you would possibly need for this figure, I think. We get the radiation painted on the arms. We get the hairdryer there. I love the little touch on the plug. It's got little silver plugs there, so really little plug points. Nicely done, and that just hangs down there too. I wonder what George was thinking. Did he not realize it was a plug? Anyway, we also get a little walkie-talkie Walkman, and a couple of sets of headphones. So maybe if we get a George down the line, you can plug that in. You can have these little headphones, very bendy, very plastic, very breakable. So be careful with them. But it does look good, and the style and the design of it is done. I mean, it's a giant yellow bloody bunny suit. It's, go with it. But it's nicely done. It's again, you don't have to buy it, but I think it's a nice touch, and a nice scene and nice packaging. I think it's a all over a pretty cool figure. I've seen a couple of people whining, "Oh, it's rubbish." Yeah. Oh gosh. Use your big words and give us a bit more detail. But you like it or you don't like it. It's up to you. I think it's a really cool figure. In terms of articulation on him, as you can see, there is a fair amount going on. There you go, as I can see, you can almost have half the helmet up there. Plenty of range in the head. There's no real restrictions. It's on that little pin joint up at the top. Just be careful taking it on and off. Joints at the arms, pretty movable. No major issues there. You can actually just see a bit of his denim jacket underneath, which is sculpted, but this is all very soft and squidgy in this giant yellow nappy. You get a double joint at the elbow. Gives you a pretty high kind of angle going on there. That's not too shabby at all. And wrists have got a swivel and a back and forth action. No waist articulation. Legs on a peg up at the top. Single joints at the knees and rocking ankles and peg holes. First, because NECA makes stands. I like it. Good solid figure. Loads of accessories. And I think that was all that came with him. Now, loads of other accessories for the other Michael J. Fox. Ultimate Marty McFly. I mean, that's a pretty cool looking figure. This is probably the favorite for everybody. The puffer jacket looks really good. Got his watch, of course, looking at the time, just like the movie poster. We got his skateboard. Let's just get a look at that, just so you can see all the parts. Valterra Madrid, I guess that was straight from the movie. I don't know. I never really paid that much attention. But there we go. Got little moving wheels. Looks like one of those skateboard collection things you can buy. It's got little screws on it as well, by the looks of it. No, it's just plastic. Nicely done. We also get a swap-out head for Marty. Glasses are a little wonky. They are kind of sitting on the top of the figure, but they're not too bad. They've applied it over the top of it. And if you want to do the full electric guitar look, as we showed on the box, knock yourself out. Doesn't really do it for me. But there you go. So really, you get two Martys in the pack. He comes with the guitar that he plays. Nicely done. Lots of nice detail on it. Got a little strap on that too, so you can have that sitting over him if you want. Plenty of moves and points. Even comes with a little hand with a pick, which I think was a nice touch by NECA. Well done them for even including that, to be honest. It also comes with a couple of swap out hands, and you do have some that's an incredibly veiny Palpatine-like hands, but you do have a couple of options there for both guitar and skateboard, camcorder, etc. So yeah, swap out if you want. The issue with this camcorder is it's a little bit delicate and fragile. It's been beautifully designed, but the microphone is so bendable. I've already nearly snapped it off, and the little piece. So even they're just touching it, I've just buggered it again. So it's really breakable. Such a shame, it's so fine. I wish they almost had just omitted that, to be honest. But in the search for likeness, this also has popped out here, this little piece, but it's not a showstopper, it's just the glue hasn't been strong enough to hold it. So it makes it a little bit difficult for him to grab and hold the camera as per the kind of show I showed you on the box. But play around with it, you'll get it to work, but just be really careful. This is very, very fragile. It is not solid at all. And that's not necessarily NECA's fault. They're trying to give you the best looking accessory here, but ultimately, you know, it is fragile. It's a small piece with even smaller parts on it, but there you go. So that is that. That's pretty much the figure. In terms of his backpack, it's nicely done too. We get some nice details on the back there too. All the folds, the weathering looks great, the leather looks fab, the denim jacket looks good. Yes, we wore denim jackets like this way back in the day, kids. I know you're probably howling with laughter, but there you go. So the backpack looks really good. It's nicely done. It's got a little split at the bottom. Again, this will snap if played around with too much. So just put it on and leave it, otherwise you're going to break things. It's really pretty thin if you can see that, so be careful. It's not really a toy. It's a posable action figure. So yeah, really nice backpack on him, and the rest of Marty just looks really good. The padding on the jacket looks fantastic. There's a bit of McFly butt. Hey, McFly. The jeans, faded jeans, yeah, we wore them too. And I had a pair of Marty's Nikes way back in the day. He's got some great socks on. Yeah, so there you go. Sneakers look good. Sneakers, trainers, whatever you call them in your country. And the denim jacket's nicely sculpted underneath before this is applied on and then glued up towards the top. And the rest of the arms and articulation patterns, his jacket, so forth, so on. He's got his kind of brown t-shirt underneath and his checkered shirt, which is nicely done. And that is a nice Michael J. Fox face. It just really works. And again, just to show you the face that comes with the other one, the Tales from Space, you can see it's generally the same hair sculpt. It's just that obviously that shocked face to this one, so slight difference. But it's cool, very good indeed. Articulation's a little stiff because of this top piece around the neck, but you do get a fair range of movement. Same exactly as the Tales of Space, arm articulation, double joints at the elbows, wrists, back and forth. We do not get waist articulation again, same old stuff. Pegs, single joint at the knees, rocking ankles, buried under there, you can just see them, there we go. And pec holes. These are excellent. We've never really had good Back to the Future figures, and I think these are excellent. It's going to be such a good line. Got a couple more to show you in another review coming up. Let us know what you think. Leave a note in the comments below, and if you want to buy it, click the link, and yeah, go pick these up. They're pretty damn cool. Thanks to the Dorkside guys. We'll see you soon.